timirandasya gyananjana shalakaya chaksurunmilitanyena tasmai shri gurave namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha kripasindubhayevacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavibhyo namo namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're recounting the travels of Gop Kumar, who was a cowherd boy from Govardhan, who was able to go to the spiritual world.
我们在讲述的是高尔丹山的一个牧牛童，他的名字叫戈帕库马尔，他的旅行，他旅行到了灵性世界。And
in the spiritual world, he met Krishna, and Krishna told him, "Oh, you're my old friend. Your name is Sarupa."
在灵性世界，主 Krishna 告诉他。 Oh, 你是我的老朋友, 你的名字叫 Sarupa.
And so we're hearing about different pastimes which took place with Lord Krishna. And we're hearing now about how Akrura came to Vrindavan to take Krishna to Mathura.
我们也讲了，在 Krishna 在那里的不同消时光，后来就讲到了 Akura 他怎么来到了 Vrindavan， 他要把 Krishna 带到 Mathura。
Now the name Akrura means somebody who is not cruel.
Akura 这个梵文词的意思就是一个。
But Akrura had been given this duty of bringing Krishna out of Vrindavan, away from the gopis, and bringing him to Kamsa. So Akrura offers his obeisances to all, each and every gopi, one by one.
Akrura, 他就开始逐一的挨个的顶拜每一个牧牛姑娘.
Because he knows the gopis are going to object to Krishna leaving them.
他知道，牧牛姑娘就是反对他。
So initially Krishna agreed that he would go with him, but before he went with Akrura, he first of all wanted to meet with the gopis and tell them that he would come back.
最后 Krishna 就同意离开了，但是首先呢，他要征得这些牧牛姑娘的允许。 并且安慰他们，向他们保证他一定会回来。So
he took the gopis. They went into a little grove, which is a little sheltered place surrounded by trees.
他Krishna 就和牧牛姑娘就一同进入了一片树丛树林， 这个树林呢，它有很茂密的树枝，就形成了一个像庇护所这样很僻静的地方。
So Akrura is appealing to Krishna that he should come to Mathura with him immediately.
Akrura 就恳求 Krishna 立刻跟他一同去 Mathura.
And he knows the gopis, they don't want to let Krishna go.
Akrura 知道公牛姑娘根本就不希望他们离开 Krishna 离开。
But Akrura tells Krishna that if you don't come to Mathura, then many people in Mathura will die.
但是 Akrura 就告诉 Krishna, 如果他不去 Mathura 的话，许多人都会就是死去。
Krishna's parents are in the prison of Kamsa, and Kamsa may kill them if Krishna doesn't come.
Krishna 的亲生父母现在就关押在 Kamsa 的监狱里。如果 Krishna 不去营救他们， Kamsa 随时可能会杀害他们。
So everybody was afraid of Kamsa, even the gopis in Vrindavan were afraid of Kamsa.
人人都惧怕 Kamsa, 连 Vrindavan 的牧牛姑娘也害怕 Kamsa.
And if Krishna doesn't go to Mathura,then many innocent people may be killed there in Mathura by Kamsa.
如果 Krishna 不去 Mathura 的话，那里很多无辜的人都会被 Kamsa 所杀害。
And the first people who Kamsa may kill are Vasudeva and Devaki, Krishna's parents.
Kamsa 可能第一个就杀害Krishna 的亲生父母 Vasudeva 和 Devaki.
So Akrura is appealing to Krishna that he should be merciful and he should go there to Mathura and save them.
所以 Akrura 就恳求 Krishna 要去仁慈的去 Mathura 来营救他的父母。
And the gopis, they should give their blessings because it's Krishna's duty to go there.
而牧牛姑娘们，她们应该祝福 Krishna， 因为呢 ，Krishna 他有责任去 Mathura。
And if gopis give their blessing, that will make Krishna's journey auspicious.
牧牛姑娘应该给出他们的祝福，让 Krishna 的此行是吉祥的。
However, the gopis say to come. The gopis reply to Akrura. They say.You great cheat, you are a follower of Kamsa, and you're speaking things which are not true.
但是这些牧牛姑娘就对 Akrura 回答他说，你这个大骗子，你是 Kamsa 的追随者，你说的话都不是真的。
And you're saying Krishna's parents,or Vasudeva and Devaki, but we know Krishna is the son of Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda.
你说 Krishna 的父母亲是 Vasudeva 和 Devaki, 可是大家都知道他的爸爸妈妈是 Nanda 和 Yashoda.
And if you take Krishna away from us, you're going to kill so many people here in Gokul, here in Vrindavan. We won't be able to live without Krishna.
如果你把 Krishna 从这里带走的话，那你就会杀死这里的许多人，在 Gokula 在 Vrindavan 的许多人都会被你杀死，因为我们都没有 Krishna， 我们都活不下去。
So the gopis think no Akrura is a servant of Kamsa.
牧牛姑娘他们就指责 Akrura 是 Kamsa 的仆人。
And Vasudeva and Devaki, the gopis are saying they're not Krishna's parents because they know that actually his eternal parents are Nanda and Yashoda.
Gopi 们牧牛姑娘们也说Vasudeva 和 Devaki 不是 Krishna 的父母亲，他的永恒的 真正的父母亲是南达和亚修的。
Vasudeva and Devaki, they become Krishna's parents just for his service, just to do some service for Krishna. But actually Nandan Maharaj and Mother Yashoda, they're the pure devotees who are always Krishna's parents.
Vasudeva and Devaki, they are to serve Krishna, to become Krishna's parents. And Nanda and Yashoda are the pure devotees, are the eternal Krishna's parents.
So the gopis are saying that you shouldn't be so much worried about Vasudeva and Devaki, you should be worried more about the gopis, the lives of the gopis.
这些牧牛姑娘就反唇相讥说，不应该担心 Vasudeva 和 Devaki， 而应该担心这些牧牛姑娘的生命安全。
We can always make some arrangement to save the people in Mathura. But Akrura could become the cause of the death of the people of Vrindavan. Not only the people, not only the gopis, but even the cows, they'll all die without Krishna.
不仅仅是Gokula的人和牧牛姑娘们，甚至Krishna走了之后，那些母牛也都会死去。
So Akrura should think carefully before he does it, before he takes Krishna away.
所以阿库拉在带走 Krishna 之前呢，应该三思而后行。
So when Krishna heard about what Kamsa was doing, and when he heard about all the misery that Krishna himself had caused to his own relatives, and when he saw that Balaram agreed with Akrura, then he apologized to the gopis.
当 Krishna 听说了康萨的暴行，也听说了他给他的亲戚造成的痛苦之后，并且他又明白巴拉拉玛也赞同了哭了，他就开始向牧牛姑娘们道歉。
Krishna showed a little bit anger and sadness. He was angry about what Kamsa was doing, and he was sad also that he was having to leave the gopis.
When Krishna 听说了 Kamsa 的那些残忍的举止之后，他就展示了一些愤怒，也展示了一些悲伤，然后他就要因为要离开 gopi 们，他就开始向他们道歉。
Lord Balaram didn't say anything. So because Balaram was not saying anything, Krishna could understand that Balaram was agreeing with what Akrura was saying, that they should go to Mathura.
Balaram, 他一言不发，因为他没有说话，所以 Krishna 就明白 Balaram 同意 Akrura 带他们去 Mathura.
So when Akrura heard this, he was very happy, and he went running to get the chariot, to bring the chariot.
当 Akrura 一听到这个消息之后，就心花怒放，就跑过去去把他的战车驾驶过来。
So when the gopis understood that Krishna was going to leave to go to Mathura, then the gopis just fixed their eyes on Krishna's face.
当牧牛姑娘们最终明白到 Krishna 要离开去 Mathura 之后，她们就用双眼死死地盯着 Krishna 的莲花脸。
And they began to cry, and they spoke, and they fell at Krishna's lotus feet and began to speak to him.
他们就开始流泪，然后就凝视着 Krishna 的，就盯着 Krishna 的莲花足不说话了。
So it was unusual for the gopis to speak to Krishna in public, but because of the situation, there was no choice.
牧牛姑娘们在公众场合当众的对 Krishna 说话，这是很少见的。但是在这种情况之下呢，他们别无选择。
Yeah, they were worried about.Being in separation, because they knew the fire of separation to be very painful for them. The gopis are not the only ones to describe their agony in separation from Krishna. They're not the only ones to express this in public in the presence of others.
这些牧牛姑娘们并不是唯一的，就在别人面前当众表白他们要与 Krishna 分离的痛苦的人们。
We already heard about the wives of the brahmanas, the Vedic brahmanas, the yajnapatnis.The Yajnapatnis were the wives of the Vedic Brahmanas, and how they left their home to come to Krishna.
We have already heard about the wives
of the Vedic Brahmanas, and how they left their home to come to Krishna.
他们希望跟 Krishna 待在一起，但是 Krishna 拒绝了，说你们应该回到你们的丈夫那里。
So the wives of the brahmanas they said to Krishna, "Oh, you should not speak such unkind words to us."
所以这些 Yajnapatnis 婆罗门的妻子们就对他对 Krishna 说，你不应该对我们说这些不友善的话。
You promised you would always reciprocate with the with your devotees.
你承诺过要永远的来回应报答你的奉献者。
Yeah, we've come to your lotus feet. We want to stay here with you at your lotus feet.
我们已经来到您的莲花足下，我们现在就想永远留在您的莲花足下了。
We're ready to give up all material relationships just to have shelter at your lotus feet.
我们现在准备就放弃一切的物质关系，一心一意的托庇于您的莲花足。
So that was the Yajnapatnis. That was there how they said. Now we're hearing about how the gopis are speaking to Krishna.
刚才是那些。举行伟大仪式的婆罗门的妻子说的一番话，接下来我们将会听到牧牛姑娘是怎么说的。
And so the gopis said, "O Krishna, we cannot live even a moment without you."
勾品牧牛姑娘们对 Krishna 说 ，Oh Krishna, 我们甚至片刻没有你，我们甚至片刻也活不下去。
We have no shelter. You should not give us up.
我们没有别的庇护所，你不应该放弃我们。
We are your maid servants. You should take us with you wherever you go.
我们都是您的女仆，无论你去哪里，你都应该带上我们。
Just for your sake, we have made the forest our home, and our home has become like the forest.
是因为为了你，我们离开家去了森林。现在森林就是我们的家，而我们的家已经变成了森林。
Our enemies have become our friends, and our friends have become enemies.
我们的敌人们已经变成了我们的朋友，而我们的朋友又变成了我们的仇敌。
And for you, because of you, poison has become like nectar for us. And nectar has become poison. Without you, we will die. So the gopis, they are sure that if Krishna doesn't accept their prayer to stay with them or to take them with him, they will die. Because of Krishna, everything in their life had changed. Their homes had become their homes. Their homes had become the forest, and the forest had become their home.
正是因为 Krishna, 一切都改变了，颠倒了。
Because in the forest they enjoy Krishna's company, so it's like their home. But their home, when they go home, Krishna's not there, so their home's empty. It has no meaning to them.
因为家中没有 Krishna, 所以他们的家是一片空虚的, 没有意义。
And they all want to get Krishna's affection, so that there's competition to get more affection from Krishna.
他们都渴望得到 Krishna的爱, 所以就有一种竞争。
So their friends were the people who helped them to meet Krishna.
那些能够帮助他们和 Krishna 相会的人是他们的朋友。
And these were the people they were actually competing with each other to get Krishna's affection.
正是与这些人，他们有着一种竞争，想要得到对 Krishna 的爱。
And people like the husbands of the gopis and the children of the gopis, they were trying to keep, they didn't want the gopis to go to Krishna, so they were like their enemies.
牧牛姑娘的丈夫、孩子们，他们想要让 Gopi牧牛姑娘们待在他们身边，不想让他们跟 Krishna 在一起，所以他们已经变成了 Gopi的敌人。The
Gopis had so much love for Krishna that it made poison into nectar.
那些牧牛姑娘是如此深爱着 Krishna， 所以他们觉得毒药就是甘露。So
for the Gopis, when they're in this separation from Krishna, they just want to die, so that poison becomes attractive to them. But nectarian thing, the things which were like nectar, are things like moonlight and sandalwood paste and nice food. They become like poison for the gopis. Although you get, they seem like sense gratification, these things are like sense gratification, but these things stop, they get in the way of associating with Krishna. And when the gopis are suffering separation from Krishna, then that pleasure, that sense gratification of these things like the moonlight and the sandalwood paste is unbearable.
公毗牟牛姑娘在与 Krishna 的分离之苦当中, 像月光和檀香浆以及美味佳肴这些能带来感官享乐的事物是难以忍受的。
So you can see, when you have pure love for Krishna, it affects people in strange ways.
所以可以看到当人拥有对 Krishna 的纯粹的爱的时候, 他们的行为举止就很奇怪。
So the gopis say, we will die a slow death if we're not able to see you anywhere. We're not able to see your beautiful smiling face and your beautiful lotus feet and your chest. Then if we can't see you, we will just die a slow death.
如果我们不能看见你美丽的、完美的莲花脸，你的莲花足，你的胸膛，如果看不见的话，我们都会慢慢的死去。So
Krishna, he's saying to the gopis, Krishna himself, he's saying to the gopis, well, I'm just going to Mathura to satisfy my well-wishers there. They have I'm the goal of their life, so I have to go and see them, but I will return.
Krishna对牧牛姑娘们说，我去Mathura是去见我的那些祝福者们，我是他们的生命目标。我去见他们，就见完之后，我就会回来的。And
you can keep yourself happy until I return. You do hearing and chanting and remembering my pastimes. In this way, you keep yourself happy.
你们可以让自己快乐，你们可以通过聆听、唱诵和意念我的消时光而变得快乐。But
the gopis, they're saying, well, if we cannot see your face for any length of time, if we can't see you in the forest or in your home, then we will die.
但是牧牛姑娘们却反唇相讥说，如果我们有片刻都看不到你，我们在森林当中或者在你的家中看不到你的话，我们都会死去。So
Krishna may argue, he may say, well, if I don't go to Mathura, then people in Mathura will have a bad, they'll give me a bad reputation that I didn't take care of them.
Krishna 可能会跟他们争辩论说，如果我不去 Mathura 的话，那么我的名声呢就不是那么好听的了，因为我不管他们。So
the gopis would say, well, we don't care what reason you have. If you leave us, we will die a slow death.
但是牧牛姑娘们却对他说：“我们不在乎，我们不在乎你这些理由。不管怎么着，如果你要离开我们的话，我们都会慢慢的死掉。”When
you go to the Vrindavan forest with the cowherd boys to enjoy your cowherd pastimes, we are able to pass the day only with great difficulty.
你白天和你的牧牛同朋友去森林共度那里的消时光的时候，这一天慢慢的白天是多么难熬啊！对我们来说，Those
days, our only hope is that in the evening you will certainly come back.
只是因为确信你傍晚一定会回来，所以这一天才。
If Krishna didn't come home in the evening, then the lives of the gopis would be finished. They'd never survive.
倘若 Krishna 晚上不回来，不回家的话, 牧牛姑娘们，她们一定会活不下去，她们的生命也就会结束了。
But they know he's going into the forest for some hours. He goes in the morning in the forest, he'll come back in the evening. So they're sure that they're going to see him again in the evening. But if you go to faraway place, if you go away to on the order of that sinful Kamsa, if you go to Mathura and to the company of his friends, then how can we live without you?
但是如果你去马图拉，去服从那个罪恶的康瑟的命令的话，去到那里去和他的那些朋友待在一起的话，那我们怎么活下去呢？
We will think about all the pain you will suffer away from home, and what we will be worried about what might happen to you. It will be impossible for us to live.
我们就会一直想着你在那里所遭受的痛苦，为你担惊受怕，我们肯定活不下去了。
So Krishna may say, well, in the big city, I'll be able to take care of myself.
Krishna 可能又会举出另外一个理由，我在那个城市会照顾好我自己的。
Just like I showed my power, my strength, I was able to defeat Kaliya, and I sent Kaliya to leave the Yamuna.
就好像我打败了卡利亚的时候，展示了我的力量，而且我命令他离开了亚穆纳河。
Of course, Krishna also said, I'm going to feel homesick when I go away from here. I'm going to feel homesick. I will feel also this pain and separation from the gopis.
Krishna 也会表达说他会害相思病，他离开他的故乡，他也会感到分离之苦。
So the gopis say to Krishna, we just worry about how much trouble you have to take to go there to kill Kamsa and all of his followers.
牧牛姑娘们，她们会说，我们就是因为你要去杀死康萨和他的党羽，你要经历了种种周折麻烦去做这个事儿，为你感到担心。
And how long will it take you to take care of the people of Mathura, to get rid of all of their problems?
你去 Mathura 去来处理他们的所有问题，你要花多久的时间呢？
And how can we be sure that you won't forget about us? That you how do we know you're going to remember us, the gopis in Vrindavan here?
我们又怎么能我们又怎么能确保你不会忘记我们在文达文的这些牧牛姑娘呢？
But Krishna may argue, he said, well, I'm going to go there, I'm going to go to Mathura, but I'm going to go with my cows, I'm going to take my cows with me, I'm going to take some friends with me, I'll take my father also, Nanda Maharaj, she will also come with me. So I won't be homesick.
但 Krishna 可能会我争辩说，我会带着我的，我会带着母牛，我的朋友们，还有我的父亲南的 Maharaj 一起去的，我不会想家的。
So the gopis give some other reasons for their problem, their distress, for their pain, that they say that we know Krishna is going to kill Kamsa, that's easy for Krishna. We know it's not difficult for Krishna to kill Kamsa.
But Krishna, now the girls are going to propose another reason. We know that for you, to express their pain and sadness, we know that for you, to kill Kamsa is not a difficult thing.
But because we know you have a lot of devotees in Mathura, will take you a long time to satisfy all their desires.
但是你在马图勒有那么多的奉献者，你要满足他们的愿望，可要要花很长的时间才能满足他们。
And Krishna may say, well, come on, I have so many girlfriends here in Vrindavan, I can't stay away from you very long.
Krishna 呢可能又会反驳他们，牧牛姑娘说，不要担心，我在这儿有那么多的女朋友，我离不开你们。
But the gopis say, well, we don't know about this, we know you'll be, it will be easy for you to forget about us if you want.
牧牛姑娘他们可能又会回复反驳说，那我们可不知道，你很容易就能忘掉我们。
So this way the gopis, they had many, they lamented a lot, and people who were, those people who were there, they all began to cry.
就这样牧牛姑娘们他们就在那里一个劲儿的悲伤，所有的在场的人都哭泣了起来。
Hearing all the complaints of the gopis just made people cry.
听到牧牛姑娘们的这些抱怨之词呢，人们都开始流泪了。
So Krishna is also crying. He takes tears from his own eyes, and he sees also the eyes of the gopis filled with tears.So he spoke with a voice, he has to speak to them before he goes.
看到牧牛姑娘们哭泣起来， Krishna 也开始哭泣起来。然后他就透过含泪，透过泪水，他就看着牧牛姑娘们。
And Krishna says to the gopis, yeah, I know this person, this enemy Kamsa, he's weak. So I will, but it will not be difficult for me to get rid of him.
Krishna 说，我知道这个邪恶的 Kamsa, 不是那么容易的把他能够消灭掉的。
So he says, you don't have to worry, I'm definitely coming back. Please don't create.Please don't cry, you don't need to worry, I'm definitely coming back to you.
Krishna 就向牧牛姑娘们保证说，你们不要担心，我肯定会回来的，你们请你们不要哭泣，不要担心，我一定回来。
So everyone came to where Krishna had been hiding, where he'd been talking to the gopis.Everybody came there, Nanda Maharaj, and all the family priests and the servants and the cows, everybody all came there.
所以现在呢，每个人都来到了 Krishna 和牧牛姑娘，藏在那个地方和牧牛姑娘们谈话的地方，包括 Nanda Maharaj, 还有他们家庭的祭司。古人母牛们都过来了。
So then Lord Krishna and Balaram, they get on the chariot, and Akrura had brought the chariot, so Krishna and Balaram got on the chariot. And Krishna somehow managed to turn his glance to stop looking at the gopis.
Akrura把战车给驾驶了过来， Krishna 和 Balarama 现在就登上了 Akura 的战车，然后他就停止，他就不再看牧牛姑娘们。
Seeing the gopis, it was a very pathetic scene. Some gopis were crying, and some were fainting, and some were on the ground, overwhelmed. They were all covered with dust. And Yashoda, Mother Yashoda came there, she was also crying.
现在的场景就是牧牛姑娘们有的他们在痛哭，而有的呢又昏倒在地上，有的就倒晕了过去，他们都内心充满了悲伤悲痛之情，浑身沾上了尘土， 亚修的妈妈也哭泣，一个劲儿哭泣和流泪。
So Nanda Maharaj was also miserable in his heart, and he didn't like to be leaving. But with great effort, he comforted his wife Yashoda.
Nanda Maharaj 内心也是痛苦不堪的，他不想离开，但是他，就试图安慰自己的妻子亚修的。
So although he was trying to comfort Yashoda, he couldn't actually get very far. It wasn't easy for him to leave.
但是虽然他努力地安慰着亚修的，但是，他很难，他却不很难离开，他走不了多远，他不太容易能够离开。
So Nanda Maharaj speaks to Mother Yashoda. He says, "Don't think I'm going happily. I'm not very happy about going to Mathura."
Nanda 对亚修的说，你不要以为我离开这里很开心，我一点也不快乐。
And I also cannot accept Krishna to be somebody else's son. Because they were saying Krishna, this Akrura was saying Krishna's the son of Vasudev and Devaki. But Nanda Maharaj said, I don't accept that.
Nanda 就对亚修的说，我也不接受。Krishna 是另别的人的儿子，因为 Akura 说，Krishna 是 Vasudeva 和 Devaki 的儿子，所以 Nanda 表示他不接受这个说法。
And I'm not going to leave him there in Mathura and come home alone.
我也不会让 Krishna 一个人待在 Mathura， 我自己回来的。
And I'm not going to let him stay there very long.
我不会让他们在马图拉待很久。
So Nanda Maharaj is not just taking Krishna to Mathura just so he can see Mathura. 嗯。Nanda Maharaj is not taking Krishna to Mathura just for sightseeing.
Nanda 大军带 Krishna 去马图拉可不是为了去那里观光的。
Mathura was a home of devotees like Vasudev and Devaki.
Mathura 是像 Devaki 和 Vasudev and Devaki 这样的奉献者的家园。
So Nanda Maharaj is going because Kamsa ordered him.
Nanda Maharaj 之所以去那里，是因为 Kamsa 下了命令。
So Mathura is the home of the Yadus, but as long as it's ruled by Kamsa, will not be a good place to visit.
虽然 Mathura 是亚度家族的成员的故乡，但是因为有 Kamsa 在那里，所以那可不是一个好地方。
So as far as Nanda is concerned, Krishna could never be the son of Vasudeva and Devaki.
So from Nanda Maharaj's 角度来说 ，Krishna 他可不是 Vasudeva 和 Devaki 的儿子。
Krishna loves Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda.
Krishna 深爱着 Nanda 大君和亚修的妈妈。
So even if Vasudev and the other Yadus were to try to keep Krishna in Mathura by force, Nanda would never return to Vrindavan without Krishna.
即便 Vasudev 和 Yadu 家族的成员们，会强迫 Krishna 留在 Mathura。但是 Nanda 他可永远不会允许 Krishna 留在 Mathura。
And even if Krishna, after killing Kamsa, if they tried to crown Krishna as the king and they want him to stay in Mathura to enjoy the kingdom, Nanda will not allow that to happen.
即便在 Krishna 杀死了 Kamsa 之后，那里的人们会把他加冕为国王， 让他享受，尽情的享受这个王国，难道也绝不会允许这种事儿？
I know that we people of Vrindavan, we cannot live for a moment without Krishna.
那就说，我知道我们这些 Vrindavan 的居民们没有 Krishna 片刻也活不下去。
So I promise you, as soon as we free Vasudeva and Devaki, we will quickly come back with Krishna.
所以我答应你们，一旦把 Vasudeva 和 Devaki 从监狱当中释放出来之后，我们会很快回到 Vrindavan。
So when they heard Nanda Maharaj make this vow, then Mother Yashoda and some of the gopis, they became a little peaceful.
当他们听到 Nanda Maharaj 发出这样的誓言之后，Yashoda 和一些宫里梦牛姑娘们内心平和了下来。
Mother Yashoda has to try to comfort the gopis and encourage them that Krishna's definitely coming back.
Yashoda 她不得不安慰梦牛姑娘，鼓励她们，告诉她们 Krishna 肯定会回来的。
Some of them were laying in front of the chariot because they said, you have to run over us if you're going to go out of Vrindavan. If you're going to leave us, you have to run your chariot over us. So Mother Yashoda, she tried to get the gopis up off the ground.
有一些牧牛姑娘们就躺在这个战车的前轱辘，轱辘面前。心想，如果你这个战车要离开Vrindavan的话，你必须得从我身上。我们身上碾过去才能离开，所以亚修的妈妈她就试图让这些牧牛姑娘站起来。
Yeah, Mother Yashoda brought some water. She sprinkled water on the gopis and got them to get up and to come back to consciousness, because some had fainted.
Nanda 和亚修的也带拿了一些水，洒有一些牧牛姑娘们，她们失去了知觉。所以南德和亚修的就拿了一些水洒在他们身上，让他们清醒过来。
So Akrura, he starts the chariot, and Nanda Maharaj, he gets in his cart, and they're following in the cart, and in this way there's a procession going to Mathura.
Akrura 的战车就这样的往前，向前面走去。南德和他的车也在后面跟随着，这样呢就有了一个长长的车队。
So the women, they have to stay back. Only the men are going, and the cowherd boys, they're going. But the women are all the gopis, they're staying back. They're not going.
离开的只有那些男子和牧牛童们，而女性还有牧牛姑娘们，她们
And so as they watched Krishna leave, their faces all dried up, and they cried again and again. They were crying, and their voices choked, and that some even ran behind the chariot.
他们就这样注视着这个车队慢慢的离开。他们的脸现在都已经枯萎了，他们的脸满脸都是泪水，有的甚至就在后面跟，他们声音也冷色了，还有的人就在后面追赶着这个车队。
And some of them held on to the chariot, and some of them even tried to fall beneath the wheels.
有的牧牛姑娘们，她们紧紧的就抓住这个车战车，还有的呢，就让自己的身体躺在了这个车轱辘下面。
They thought either we will stop the chariot or we will be killed.
他们心想，我们要么就让这个战车停止步伐，要么呢，我们就干脆死掉。
So the cows and the bulls and the calves and the deer, all the animals, they all stood around the chariot And their faces were all covered with tears.
那些母牛、公牛、牛犊、鹿儿，还有动物们，都围绕着这个车战车，他们的脸上都是流着泪水。
Even the wild animals like the wolves and the jackals, that they came there, they were also, they also joined with the other animals lamenting Krishna's departure.
甚至像，狼、豺狼和虎狼这样的野兽们，他们也和其他们的动物们一道为 Krishna 的离别而感到悲伤。
And all the birds were flying around, they were making a lot of noise, and the leaves of the plants, they all dried up.
飞鸟们他们都围绕着这个战车发出很多的叫声，还有植物的叶子都枯萎了，干枯了。
There were some tall mountains, some big mountains there, and some stones fell down from the mountain, and some big trees fell down.
高山上面的一些大树也倒下了，还有这个山上也滚下了这个山石。
And some rivers even became dry.
有的河流都干枯了。
And some rivers changed direction, and instead of flowing down, they were flowing backwards.
有的河流它们改变了流向，它们没有向下游流去，它们反而向上游流去。
Govardhan is a big mountain, and so some of the stones fell down, some of the trees fell down from Govardhan.
高尔丹山是一个巨大的山脉，就从这个山上呢，有一些大树就忽然倒了下来，还从山上也滚落了巨石。
So when Krishna saw all his devotees in so much pain, Krishna also felt a lot of pain and sorrow in his heart.
Krishna 看到奉献者们他们内心的痛苦。Krishna 自己内心也感到非常的难过和悲伤。
Krishna couldn't stop them crying, and his own eyes were also filled with tears.
Krishna 自己也止不住哭了起来，满眼都是泪水。
So Akrura was worried that maybe Krishna would get down from the chariot and go away again. So.He made sure that Krishna didn't get off the chariot.
Akura 担心 Krishna 会从战车上下来再次跑开，所以他确保 Krishna 不会离开这个战车。
So he's holding on to Krishna and he's supporting Krishna because he's worried maybe Krishna will also faint and fall down.
所以 Akura 就紧紧地抓住了 Krishna， 就扶住了 Krishna， 他担心 Krishna 也会昏倒。
So Akura he'd been a servant of the rulers of the kingdom for a long time, so he had a lot of experience in how to handle these things.
所以 Akura 呢，他身为统治者的仆人。他做了很长时间的统治者的仆人，他有切身的体验，该怎么处理这种情景。
So finally he's on the way to go to Mathura with Krishna. He doesn't want anything to go wrong.
最后他们终于走上了去 Mathura 的道路，确保一切都是安然无事，顺利利的。
So he made a show, it appears like he's holding on to Krishna, that he doesn't want Krishna to fall off. But actually, the point is he doesn't want Krishna to run away.
Akura 的表面上好像是 扶住 Krishna 好像是不让 Krishna 晕倒的样子，是装样，然后实际上他内心呢是不希望 Krishna 跑下来。
And so worried that Krishna was about to faint, Akrura took permission from Balaram and from Nanda Maharaj and the others, and he made the horses, he cracked the whip and made the chariot go, start to go.
Akrura 他担心 Krishna 晕倒，所以他就征得了 Balarama 和 Nanda 的允许，还有别人允许，他就挥动了鞭。
So he was driving the chariot very carefully. He has to swerve a little bit. So he doesn't want to run over any animals or any gopis who may fall on the road. So the gopis are just watching and they're crying, just like the kurari birds cry when there's no rain. So Akrura drove off with Krishna, and Akrura, he's like an eagle who's got a piece of fish in his mouth.
Sorry.
Just like an eagle, a big bird, when they catch a fish, then they're very proud and they're very swift to fly off with that fish to go and eat the fish.
就好像一只鹰。当他抓住一条鱼的时候，就会急速的飞开，好让这个鱼不要跑掉一样。
Right, the ego can be very cruel like that. They've got a big fish. They're going to eat the fish. They don't worry. So Akrura is like that ego.
就好像一只抓住了一条大鱼的鹰，非常残忍的。不让这只大鱼跑掉了一样，阿库拉，你就像这只鹰一样残忍。
Okay, we'll stop here today.
好，那我们今天就讲到这里。
Any questions?
Yes. 第一个问题是来自于Rajendra。Oh, as the first question is from last Saturday.
Okay.
请问 Guru Dev, 如果觉得 Krishna 给予什么安排都能接受，那么就不需要祈福了吗？处于这种心态，感觉没有情感的交流和表达，内心变得坚硬了。The first question is from Sati Dasi. Gurudev, if we feel that whatever arrangement Krishna makes, we will accept, then there's no need to pray. If we are in this kind of mood,then there will be no exchange and expression of feeling, and our heart will be hard. She asked that if we accept whatever Krishna arranges, then are there any need for us to pray?
Yes.We want, you know, prayer is not just to ask for something.
You mean we should pray or not?
We should pray, but it's not that when every time we pray, we have to tell Krishna what we want.
我们是还是需要祈祷的，但是并不是说我们每次祈祷的时候都要告诉 Krishna 我们要什么，要求什么。
Just like Lord Brahma, Lord Brahma's prayers, when we sing the Govinda prayers, Lord Brahma is not asking Krishna anything.
就好像婆罗诃摩赞主 Brahma 对 Govinda 的祈祷，他并没有向 Krishna 要求什么。
He's just glorifying Krishna.
他只是在那里荣耀 Krishna.
I worship Govinda, who's adept in playing the flute with blooming eyes like lotus petals, whose head is bedecked with peacock feather, whose figure of beauty is tinged with the hue of blue clouds, and whose unique loveliness is charming millions of cupids. Just glorifying Krishna.
我崇拜原始的主狗温达，他的双眼好像盛开的莲花，他吹奏着笛子，头插孔雀羽毛，他的美丽，他肤色美丽就好像新鲜的云朵，他独一无二的俊美迷住了千百万的丘比特。主 Brahma 是这样荣耀着 Krishna， 他只是在荣耀 Krishna。
If you look in the prayers in the Srimad Bhagavatam.You'll see the devotees, they don't ask Krishna anything. They're just glorifying Krishna.
在圣典伯加瓦坛当中，我们看到那些奉献者们，他们对 Krishna 的祈祷，他们并没有在要求，他们只是在荣耀。
Krishna knows everything. He knows about the problems we have, the dangers we may be in. He knows all about it.
Krishna 他无所不知，他知道我们的问题，他知道我们的危险处境，他知道。
We just have to take, we have to remember Krishna. That's the point. Not that you have to tell Krishna what you need, what you want. You just have to remember Krishna, and remembering Krishna means we glorify him, talk about his wonderful qualities.
要点是我们要记住 Krishna， 并不是告诉 Krishna。
We should be thinking Krishna is so wonderful, Krishna is so amazing。
并不是向 Krishna 告诉他我不需要什么，而是记住 Krishna， 荣耀 Krishna 的品质。Krishna 是这么美妙的一个人。
It shouldn't be dry. You should be happy to do all this.
Hare Krishna.
Mm-hmm.
Good day. 是这样，我是想问，就是我们现在在为圣地的这些奉献者们祈祷吗？就是如果我们内心想着所有的一切的安排都是 Krishna 的最好的安排的话，那可能我们对这个圣父的奉献者们的这种祈祷的内心就不是那么，就是这种情感就没有那么充分的这种表达或是那种焦急的这样一个心态。我觉得这个就是我的疑惑是在这儿。Hare Krishna。
Yeah, but we have to accept that Krishna's arrangement is perfect.
是的，但是我们也要接受 Krishna 的一切安排都是完美的。
A devotee remains surrendered to Krishna. Whatever Krishna wants to do, whatever happens, we accept it as Krishna's arrangement. We just take shelter of Krishna and remember him more.
我们要接受的是 Krishna 的奉献者们，他们会接受 Krishna 的安排是完美的，他们会臣服 Krishna， 无论 Krishna 要什么，他们都会加以接受，这都是 Krishna 的安排，他们会更加记住 Krishna， 更加托庇 Krishna。
Yeah, we're going to pray, not that we're going to pray Krishna, oh save me, oh Krishna help me, but we'll just simply pray that let me remember Krishna.
We're not 祈祷 Krishna 会救我们， 快乐帮助我们，而是说祈祷。Krishna, 请让我们记住你。
And if we are in a very life-threatening situation, then we can pray to Krishna also to save us.
如果我们是处在那种就是紧要的，就是生命处在紧要关头，紧急关头的时候，我们可以向 Krishna 祈祷救命。
That is not against pure devotion. That is still considered pure devotion. But we don't do that all the time, not every day.
这也不反对，不违反纯粹父爱服务的原则。但是我们并不是一直总是在这样祈祷，天天这么祈祷。
Okay.
我说曼尼曼丹吉，您的这个麦你还调整一下，声音有点小了。
好的，好。
下一个问题。
下一个是 Honor， 这个是华为手机 Light， 对，所以顶拜 Guruday 的莲花组，顶拜主持。前年见 Guru 后，每一个礼拜都参加联谊，尽量做服务，至今收获不大。请问姑怎么做奉献？怎么做奉献服务 ？So this new devotee, he or she paid obeisance to Guru's lotus feet, and the year before last year, this devotee has met Guru, and after that.Every week, this devotee will go for association, try to do devotional service. Every week will go for association, but this devotee felt that there are not much benefit. This devotee felt that she or he hasn't got a lot of.Gain benefits from this. So she asked, this devotee asked Guru how to do devotional service.
Well, devotional service begins with hearing and then chanting. So you want to do devotional service, you simply have to hear about Krishna. You pick up one of the books and read. Then you go to associate with the devotees, you read the book. You can read the book to the devotees.
奉献服务始于聆听、唱诵。奉献服务只是就去聆听有关于 Krishna 的事迹。像说，你只需要拿起一本书来读就好了。当你去联谊的时候，你就在联谊那儿去读书。
So that is beneficial. That is good for you because that will purify your heart.
这对你会有好处，有收获，这将净化心灵。
And going to be with the devotees, you will also worship Krishna. You'll see how to worship Krishna.
当你去和奉献者们联谊的时候，你可以去看他们，向他们学习他们怎么崇拜 Krishna 的。
And you can also share with them your questions and your doubts about Krishna and see how they respond.
You can share with them your questions and your doubts about Krishna and see how they respond.
So sometimes we feel we're not getting much benefit, but actually you're getting benefit because you're protected from sinful activities. In the association of devotees, there will be no sinful activities.
你觉得没有得到好处，但实际上通过联谊你得到了保护，不会从事罪恶活动，因为在联谊的时候是没有任何罪恶活动的。
you go and associate with people who are not devotees, then it will be much worse.
如果你和非奉献者联谊的话，那会糟糕得多。
They will be drinking tea and coffee. They will be talking very mundane things. No talk of Krishna.
他们会喝酒、喝咖啡、喝茶。他们会谈论世俗的话题。他们不会谈论 Krishna。
So you should try to understand the importance of association with devotees.
所以你应该努力去明白要跟奉献者联谊它的重要性。
And you should try to serve the devotees. Service to the devotees is very good for you and very purifying.
你要去努力服务奉献者。服务奉献者可以，这对您是非大有好处的，可以净化您。
Service to the devotees begins with hearing about Krishna. So I said, you read to them, you take a book, and you read to them about Krishna, and then you ask questions about Krishna.
服务就源于聆听，所以您，应该向给奉献者朗读。有关于 Krishna 的这个书籍和 Krishna 的这些事情，然后问问题，对他们提出有关于 Krishna 的问题。
Try to understand this Krishna conscious philosophy.
努力的去理解这门 Krishna 知觉的哲学。
Okay, 下一个问题。
下一个问题。Rajendra Prabhu, Akura 去跟他们接 Krishna Balarama 去 Mathura 是属于他的职责，然后得到 Gopi 的诅咒，导致后来 Akura 参与 Shamatanka 宝石的阴谋。请问，履行职责还会招来诅咒吗？ This is the first question. Akura come to fetch Krishna Balarama to Mathura out of duty, but he was cursed by gopis, and later on, he participated in this story of stealing Shamatanka, a jewel. So my question is that if we carry out our duty and we'll incur curse from others, right? Is that we will...The others will curse us when we carry out our duties, even if we carry out our duty.
Well, we have to do our whatever service is required for the service of Krishna.
就是无论有什么需要服务的需要，那我们必须要去做，履行我们的职责。
Just like a devotee may be cursed, but that cursing can be a blessing for him.
就像一个奉献者可能会受到诅咒，但是这个诅咒对他来说可能会是反而是一个祝福。
Just like Narada Muni, he preached to the sons of Daksha and he made them devotees and he told them, don't go home. So Daksha cursed Narada Muni that he would never be able to stay in any one place. So this was a blessing for Narada Muni.
Narada Muni 向 Daksha 的儿子们传教，然后就遭到 Daksha 的，他就传教让他们不要回家。就遭到 Daksha 的诅咒，诅咒拿的穆尼不会在一个地方停留，所以这个对拿的穆尼来说是一个祝福。
So, devotee, what may appear to be a cursing can also be a blessing.
对于奉献者而言，就是表面上的诅咒反而有可能是一个祝福。
A devotee will simply act, do what is required for the service of Krishna. So Akrura had to do the service, he had to bring Krishna to Mathura.
你一个奉献者，他们必须要根据他们的服务来采取相应的行动。 所以 Akrura 他必须要从事这个把 Krishna 带到 Mathura 的服务。
We have to do what's required for pleasing Krishna. We don't think about what we want. We're not worried about, a devotee's not worried about being cursed or blessed or whatever. A devotee just simply thinks, what is my duty for service to Krishna?
一个奉献者他们会去做需要去做的取悦 Krishna。他们并不考虑自己的要求，他们也不考虑他们会不会遭到诅咒或者祝福之类的，他们只是想着他们要从事什么样的职责来去服务。
Just like Arjuna, you know, Arjuna was worried about fighting, he was worried about so many things. But Krishna told him, just do your duty in a detached manner.If you do it for karma, as karma yoga, there's no reactions.
就像 Arjuna 他在战场上他有很多的担心，但是 Krishna 鼓励他，你只需要履行的职责，你要以一种不依附的心态履行职责，从事 karma yoga 行动瑜伽。
May appear like reactions.But devotee is transcendentally situated, he's detached.
表面上看来好像会招致一些就是业报反应，但是奉献者们他们是超然的，他们是气绝不依附的。
Devotee is detached, happiness or distress, it's all the same.
无论快乐和痛苦，对奉献者都是一样的。他们因为他们是不依附的，不执着的。
Devotee has to be tolerant in every situation.
奉献者们在一切的处境下都是容忍的。
Okay. 下一个问题。
第二个。继续那个是在解脱层面上还会被诅咒吗？如何化解？为了 Guru 和 Krishna 承担诅咒有什么下场吗？He continued with the second part of the question is that, even on the level of liberated stage, will still be cursed. So how to dissolve that curse?And what will be the consequence that we bear, undertake the curse for the sake of Guru and Krishna?
Well, you see, for example, Garuda was coming to the Yamuna and he was taking fish from the Yamuna, and so Bari Muni cursed him.
我们有一个例子是Garuda 他去杨的河去抓鱼，结果呢 Sobari Muni 就诅咒了 Garuda。
Sobari Muni cursed if Garuda comes here again to take fish he will certainly die.
Sobari Muni 就诅咒了 Garuda 说假设他再次来杨的河抓鱼的话就会死。
So GarudaHe, you know, Garuda is very powerful. He's the direct servant of Lord Vishnu, and he's for Subari Muni to curse him, it was an offense.
Garuda, 他是主 Vishnu 的直接的仆人，所以他是非常有力量的。对于 Subari Muni 来说，他诅咒 Garuda 是冒犯。
But Garuda accepted the curse, and he didn't come there again to take fish.But the result for Subari Muni was Subari Muni fell down.
但是 Garuda 他接受了这个诅咒，他不再去杨的河抓鱼了。 但是对于萨巴尔穆尼来说，结果他却堕落了。
So one should be very careful. You know, people put curses on devotees. It's very dangerous. You know, they may get them, it can be an offense and they will suffer.
所以要小心，因诅咒奉献者是非常危险的，有可能会造成冒犯，就导致受苦。
It's not the business of devotees to curse people. Rather, we try to bless people.
奉献者的事物并不是诅咒别人，相反，奉献者的事物是祝福别人。
Narada Muni, when he met the sons of Kuvera, Nala Kuvera and Manigriva, and they were naked.So he was upset. So he put them into bodies of trees, but that was a blessing for them. It was a punishment, but at the same time it was a blessing because Lord Krishna would come and deliver them.
当 Narada Muni 他遇见了 Kuvera 的两个儿子 Manigriva 和 Nala Kuvera 的时候，这两个儿子他们是赤身裸体的，所以 Narada Muni 特别不安，就诅咒了他们，结果他们变成了树木。这个诅咒呢，虽然是一个惩罚，但反而是一个祝福，因为后来这两个儿子他们遇见了主 Krishna。
So sometimes these curses they have some other reason behind them. There's some other purpose, some higher purpose behind it.For the good of the person, rather than to harm them.
有的时候这些诅咒他们是事出有因的，他们有更高的原因，有更高的目的，是对于那些被诅咒的人是对他们有好处的，他们不会伤害他们，反而会给他们带来好处。
Okay.
下一个问题。So how to understand the curse from the gopi? He continued to ask.
How to understand the curse of the gopis, which they gave to Akrura? Well,Yeah, the gopis were not pleased with Akrura because he took Krishna away from them. And what curse they put on them, the gopis didn't know anything about the Shamantaka jewel. But it just happened like that, that Akrura got involved with the Shamantaka jewel.
Gopis must have
been
very upset.但是这个他们没有诅咒阿库热，这个沙曼坦卡宝石，这个事情它是另外一码事，它恰恰就发生了，然后阿库热他就卷入了这个事件。
阿库热 is one of the great devotees, and he's our acharya in offering prayers to Krishna, right? The nine processes of bhakti yoga.And there's the examples of devotees who each achieve perfection by one of the different nine processes. So Akrura achieved perfection by offering prayers.
Akrura, he is a great acharya, he is a great acharya, he is a great acharya.每项奉献服务达到完美，通过这个服务达到完美，有一个代表人物。那库拉是因为向主供奉祈祷而达到完美的这样的一个代表。
So we have to understand, this is all due to the pastime potency all of these different things are taking place, the different events, to allow Lord Krishna to perform more pastimes.
我们也要明白的是，这一切都是由于Lila 就是消时光的能量，它的这个作用导致的，是为了让不同的事件发生，好让 Krishna 他上演他的消时光。
So Akrura, he had to come there to Vrindavan to bring Krishna to Mathura. Krishna had to go to Mathura. The gopis didn't like it, but this brings out the love of the gopis. We're able to understand more the power and the purity of the gopis' love for Krishna.
Akrura, he went to Vrindavan, brought Krishna to Mathura.然后勾皮们心里不高兴，并不喜欢，但是这件事就反而就是展示了勾皮们他们对 Krishna 的纯洁无瑕的爱。
If Krishna just stayed in Vrindavan, then we won't have any Kurukshetra, we won't have Krishna speaking the Bhagavad Gita, we won't have any Dwarka Lila, we'll miss a lot of pastimes.
如果 Krishna 他就是待在 Vrindavan 的话，那接下来就没有 Kurukshetra 战役， Krishna 也没有 Krishna 在战场上讲述国家梵歌，他也没有接下来的 Dwarka 的消时光，就缺失了很多的消时光了。
So Krishna performed his pastimes in Vrindavan. He gave a lot of mercy to the gopis there. And when he left Vrindavan to go to Mathura, actually Krishna never leaves Vrindavan.But Vasudev Krishna went to Mathura, and Shamsundar Krishna, the original form of Krishna, hid himself in the hearts of the gopis.
When Krishna he 离开去 Mathura, Krishna 在 Vrindavan 消时光，就给了牧牛姑娘巨大的仁慈。后来当 Krishna 离开去 Mathura 的时候，其实他是没有离开 Vrindavan， 离开的是 Vasudev Krishna， 而 Shama Sundar Krishna 就是 Krishna 最原初的形象是藏在了勾皮牧牛姑娘们的心中了。
So Krishna is eternally in Vrindavan. He's always there.
Krishna 他永恒的就在 Vrindavan.
Sometimes he's manifest.And often, most times he's not.
有的时候他展示，大部分时候他不展示。
5,000 years ago, he was manifest. His pastimes were manifest.
在五千年前呢，他的消时光是展示出来的。
But he's eternally there in Vrindavan.
但他永恒的在 Vrindavan.
And he's in the hearts of the gopis.
他在勾皮牧牛姑娘们的心中。
下一个问题。
下一个，超然层面上有诅咒的发生吗？与物质层面的诅咒有什么区别吗 ？So, Rajan Babu continue to ask. The first question is. Are there any?In a case of cursing on the platform, on transcendental platform, what's the distinction between the curse on the transcendental platform and the curse on the material platform?
Well, on the transcendental platform means you're dealing with Krishna and Krishna's pure devotees.
超然层面的诅咒是跟 Krishna 有关的，是跟 Krishna 的纯粹奉献者有关的。
Just like, if you read the Brahma Vaivarta Purana describes about the pastimes of Tulsi, and we read about how Radharani, what, I can't remember now all the details, but there's a lot of cursing goes on, and one of Krishna's friends, Sudama, he's cursed and he becomes a demon. He becomes a demon, becomes a big Rakshasa. But it's all for more pastimes.
就是在 Brahma Vaivarta Purana当中呢 有关于Tulasi的消失光 Krishna的朋友 Sudama 他就受到了诅咒 变成了恶魔 Rakshasi.
And in this way Sudama has a pastime. He becomes as a demon. His wife is the goddess of fortune, and so Sudama becomes, I can't remember all the details, but there's a lot of cursing there. And that's all transcendental to unfold more Krishna pastimes. As a result of the cursing, you've got Shalagram Shilas, and Shalagram Shila is worshipped by Tulsi, and it's all unfolded due to the cursing of different devotees.
就在这个消失当中时光当中有很多诅咒发生这些诅咒都导致了就是更多的逍遥时光的逐渐的展开就在这个消失当中就具有了那个Shalagram Shila菊石Shalagram Shila后来Tulsi就嫁给了Shalagram Shila这些呢就是就由 就是因为这些诅咒，很多的诅咒就导致了更多的逍遥时光的上演。
So material cursing, you know, when Daksha cursed Narada Muni, it was material, but because he cursed the devotee, it became transcendental, it became beneficial for Narada Muni.
在那个 Daksha 就诅咒Narada Muni这个事件当中呢，这是个物质的诅咒，但是呢，因为他是诅咒的纯粹奉献者，所以这是一个超然的，也是有好处，也带来了好处。Daksha
thought it was going to be very bad for Narada Muni not to be able to stay more than 3 days because Daksha is a materialist.
当时他心里想，诅咒Narada Muni就在一个地方停留的时间不能超过三天，是非常糟糕的、不好的，因为他是一个物质主义者，他这么想。But
for a transcendentalist like Narada Muni, it's very good, very convenient.
但是对于像Narada Muni这样一个超然主义者来说，这是个诅咒是很好的，对他来说很方便。
So materialistic people, non-devotees, they will curse each other, they will curse people to take away their material opulence, to take away their material sense gratification.
物质主义者还有非奉献者，他们诅咒别人，就是会他们诅咒拿走别人的物质。
So that would be material, but to a devotee this could be also very transcendental. Devotee thinks Krishna's mercy to take away everything.
奉献者们他们觉得 Krishna 通过这种方式拿走一切，这是一个祝福。
OK.
下一个问题来自于珍珍。 Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Gurudev, 顶拜主持人和所有的奉献者。 Hare Krishna mantra 的力量是来自每一个名字，是吗？这个力量和名字的排列顺序关系是什么？和名字本身的关系是什么？请求姑姑解惑，烦姑的。So this 真正 ask said Hare Krishna obeisance to the obeisance to host and all devotees, and the power of Hare Krishna mantra comes from each name. Is that right? She has several questions.
Okay, so the power, the mantra comes in the holy name, yes?
是的，是的。Hare Krishna mantra 的力量来自每个名字。And continue?
Yeah.
And she continued to ask, what's the relationship between the power of the mantra and the sequence of the arrangement of each name?
Well, the arrangement of the names is put in such a way that it becomes a mantra. Without that arrangement, it's not a mantra, it's not going to deliver the mind.
This name's arrangement is to make it become a mantra. If there is no such arrangement, it cannot be saved, it cannot be saved, it cannot be
By the combination of the names and the arrangement of the names produces a special sound vibration, a particular transcendental sound vibration which delivers the mind.
通过这个名字的组合和名字的这个安排就起到了一种特殊的声振的效果，是一种超然的音振。它能够将心意从烦恼当中解脱出来。
It's not just only chanting the name, one name, but you have to chant the mantra. And the mantra is going to be much more powerful than just the one name.
所以这个不是，我们唱诵的不是仅仅是一个名字，而是唱诵的是一首mantra, 曼陀罗。那这个曼陀罗它比仅仅一个名字要更加有力量。
下一个问题。
Yes, the next part is that what's the relationship between this arrangement of the mantra and the name itself?That maybe you have answered the question.
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. 那这个我已经回答了Guru下一个问题，是来自于 Shruti Rupa Pedasi Hare Krishna 顶拜Guru和老师们，有新人提问：一，该如何以 Krishna 之觉来看待目前印度疫情大泛滥的情况，以及普通民众和圣人同时被感染的区别？Shruti Rupa Devadasa asked Hare Krishna obeisance to Guru and all teachers. There are neophyte who raised the question that how to see the present situation that in India there are a lot of outbreak from this COVID-19 and a lot of general populace are affected, and at the same time the holy people.They are also, the sadhu, they are also affected. What's the difference between the case that the general populace are affected and also the sadhu, they are also affected?
Yes. Sadhus are also affected, the holy...The devotees are also affected. But the suffering of the devotee is not on the same level as the suffering of the ordinary people.
奉献者们的他们的受苦和普通人的受苦不在一个层面上。
The suffering of the devotee helps to bring the devotee closer to Krishna.
奉献者们他们的受苦是为了把他们更加带，让他们更加接近 Krishna， 离 Krishna 更近了。
The suffering of the non-devotee, they go further away from Krishna.
而非奉献者们的受苦使他们更加远离 Krishna。
So material body means suffering. We accepted the material body. We came in the material world. It means there will be suffering. There will be, because we took birth, there will be old age, there will be disease, there will be death.
物质躯体它就是意味着要受苦。在物质世界，只要是在物质世界都要遭受痛苦。
But we
只要有这物质躯体就意味生老病死。
We shouldn't think the death of a devotee is like the same as the death of a non-devotee.
我们不要以为奉献者的死亡离世和非奉献者的死亡离世是一样的。
Devotee dies to go to Krishna, to take up more devotional service for Krishna.
奉献者们的离世是去为了去 Krishna 那里，是为了接受更多给为 Krishna 从事更多的服务。
He leaves this world to go to the real world in the spiritual world.
他们离开这个世界，他们去真实的世界，去灵性世界。
But the non-devotees, they're going to go to Yamaraj.
而非奉献者他们会去阎罗王 Yamaraj 那里。
That's a big difference.
所以有着天壤的区别。
下一个问题。
So this new devotee asked how to see from point of Krishna consciousness the situation now that in India.The pandemic is very serious, a lot of outbreak, the cases a lot.
Yes, everywhere people are dying, everywhere there's disease. There's nowhere in this world, material world, where there's no disease. There's old age, there's disease, there's death. This earth planet, this is a place of death. This is...Mritu Loka. Everybody's dying. We're all dying. So some places people are dying quicker and other places people are dying slower. But everyone's dying.
In this world, there's no one who can escape death. This world is called Mritu Loka.就是每个人都要死，而在有的地方呢，就是有的地方的人死得快一点，有的地方呢他们会死得慢一点，但是最终人人都要死去。
You may live a few years more in your country, doesn't mean any. It's not, you know, people in India may be dying quicker, you're dying, but you're still going to die. You're not going to avoid death.Are you ready to die?
在你们的国家呢，可能能多活几年，但是在印度呢，他们可能就是死得快一点，但是，但是最终仍然要死去，这个死亡是不可避免的。你做好准备，做好死亡的准备了吗？
Okay.
下啊，有第二个问题。有人提出，学习薄伽梵歌之后，确认了 Krishna 是至尊主，也相信自己是个体灵魂，但是没有信心这辈子就回灵性世界。目前只想通过 Krishna 知觉提升知觉和能力，更好的工作挣钱，更好与家人。 当初先把预备的活好，请问Guru要达到这个目标该怎么做呢？Somebody asked that after studying Bhagavad Gita, they believe that Krishna is the Supreme Lord, and they also believe they are the individual soul, but they don't have the faith that they can go back to the spiritual world in this lifetime. So for the present moment, they only want to, through the Krishna consciousness, they want to do better their own job and to earn money and to have more friendly relationship with the family members. And they think that it's better that for them to have a good life in this lifetime. And so the question is that for this purpose, what should they do?
Well, what can we say? That means that they're very attached to the material situation. Ultimately, they will see their material situation as temporary. They say they want to have a better life, but for how long? They can't have a better life for very long, a little while. Gradually, they're going to come closer to death. They're going to get old, they're going to get disease, they're going to have to prepare for death. So at that time, they may remember about Bhagavad Gita.
逐渐的，他们渐渐的呢，就能逼近老年、疾病、死亡，然后到那个时候呢，他们就能想起无家梵歌了。So
we hope so anyway. We hope that some time will come when they will remember Bhagavad Gita and they'll think a bit more again about what they learned from the Bhagavad Gita.
所以，嗯，就是说，希望呢，他们呢，在 某一个时间呢，他们就能记起薄伽梵歌，记起他们学到的薄伽梵歌的知识。
Okay.
下一个问题来自，应该是智敏，顶拜Guru，感谢您。牧牛姑娘有些神圣和超然的地位，他们可以跟 Krishna 沟通，而我们不能，我们得去服务灵性导师。 怎么才能和灵性导师建立更通透的连接呢? The basis to Guru, because the gopis, they are divine and they are transcendental, they can communicate with Krishna directly, but we cannot. We have to serve the spiritual master. So the question is that how can we have a more pure connection with the spiritual master. Transparent
okay.
connection.
Uh-huh. Yes, well, if you see the spiritual master as the representative of Krishna, then you should think that whatever you're communicating with the spiritual master is also going to Krishna.
灵性导师是 Krishna 的代表，所以无论你跟灵性导师之间是什么样的沟通，他们都会传递给 Krishna.
Now you say you cannot have direct communication with Krishna, but you can. Krishna is in your heart. Krishna knows everything. He hears everything.
你说你不能跟 Krishna 直接沟通，但是你是可以沟通的，因为 Krishna 就在你的内心。Krishna 知道一切，而且 Krishna 也听到一切。
So you, we can all have a direct connection, communication with Krishna.
我们都可以跟 Krishna 有个直接的沟通。
You have to practice. You have to learn to speak to Krishna. You have to practice. You have to cultivate that habit of talking to Krishna, and He hears everything you say.
你可以学习，学习怎么就是跟 Krishna 沟通，跟培养去修习培养。就这种习惯跟 Krishna 说话的习惯 Krishna 他能听到你说的一切
Krishna's in everything He's in the deity He's in his holy name And he's in the hearts of his devotees
Krishna 在一切当中他在神像中 Krishna 也在他的圣名中Krishna 也在他奉献者的内心。
So you have to regularly speak to Krishna, and you have to tell him your problems, tell him your difficulties, that you have, you don't have much faith, you don't have a lot of understanding of Krishna consciousness, and you have to ask Krishna to help you, to bless you.
你应该有规律地跟 Krishna 讲话，把你的问题难处告诉他，告诉 Krishna 你没有那么多的信心，你不理解 Krishna 直觉，请求 Krishna 帮助你，请求 Krishna 祝福你。
Don't think Krishna cannot hear. Krishna hears everything.
你不要以为 Krishna 听不见， Krishna 什么都听见了。
Krishna knows everything. He knows what we're thinking, and he can definitely hear what we're saying.
Krishna 无所不知 Krishna 知道我们的所思所想，而且 Krishna 肯定也能听到我们说的话。
He knows Chinese. He knows all the languages. He can even speak with the animals and the birds.
Krishna 也懂中文 Krishna 他懂所有的语言他甚至能够理解动物的语言和鸟类的语言
OK 下一个问题
下一个 Panchatattva 不顶拜马尔顶拜你所顶拜所有奉献者温达文的一切都处在纯粹状态奉献者如何处在这样的知觉中呢Panchatattva Prabhu pay obeisance to obeisance of Maharaj and all devotees. Everything in Vrindavan is in the pure stage. So how can devotee also situated in such kind of consciousness?
Well, first I offer my obeisances to Panchatattva, and I think.We want to experience Vrindavan consciousness. We have to hear about Vrindavan.
首先就是马尔说他也顶拜潘查塔的帕布。如果我们想要体验 Vrindavan 的知觉，首先要聆听有关于 Vrindavan 的事情。
We want to develop the consciousness of Vrindavan.We want to develop, think of Krishna. We're thinking of Krishna. Krishna's always in Vrindavan. And in Vrindavan, everything is, everyone, every living entity is devotee, is in pure consciousness.
We want to develop Vrindavan's 知觉的话我们需要发展起这种知觉。在 Vrindavan, 所有生物他们时时刻刻都在想着 Krishna。Krishna 也总在 Vrindavan Vrindavan 的一切生物，他们都是处在纯粹的知觉当中。
Yeah, when you see the Songjiang, and the Songjiang, you should think this is the Yamuna, and when you see a mountain, you should think this is the Govardhan. When you see the trees, you should think these are Kalpa Vriksha trees.
就当您看见那个松江，就是这个河的时候呢，每次看到这河，你就联想起了杨的河。而每当你看到一座山的时候，你就联想起了高登山。而每当你看到一棵树的时候，你就联想起这是一棵如愿树。
Think of all of Krishna's pastimes by remembering Krishna's pastimes, and by remembering the glories of Krishna, then we will feel also that Vrindavan consciousness.
当你想着就是所有这些消时光，记起所有这些消时光，想着 Krishna 的所有的这个荣耀的话，你就能够感受到了 Vrindavan 的知觉。
So we want to practice remembering Krishna's pastimes. We're hearing about Krishna, about just today we're hearing about Krishna leaving Vrindavan, going to Mathura. This is Krishna's pastimes.
所以我们要修行，记住 Krishna 消时光，聆听 Krishna 消时光。今天我们听到的是 Krishna 离开 Vrindavan 去 Mathura 的消时光。
We want to remember all of these pastimes. We want to be thinking how painful it must have been for the gopis and how painful it was for Krishna to leave Vrindavan.
So we want to remember these passing moments. We must think about the gopis and Munyu Girl. Their hearts are so deep, and for Krishna.Krishna 离开，要离开 Vrindavan， 他也是多么深刻的痛苦。
还有问题吗？
Nine questions more.
Have we got time? I have time. I'm not busy today.
I have time too.
Okay, let's go ahead then. We'll try to do it quickly.
Okay.下一个问题是来自于 Yuna Hare Krishna Kumara. Please accept my humble obeisance of our Krishna Prabhupada said that we have free choice, free will. However, if Krishna is all-knowing, does he know what choice we will ultimately make? Thank you. 这个问题来自于 Yuna Hare Krishna Kumara. 接受我谦卑礼拜。据说我们都有自由意志，那么如果 Krishna 无所不知，他知道我们会做什么样的选择吗？感谢您。
Yes, Krishna knows everything.
是的 ，Krishna 无所不知。
So he knows what we're going to do.
他知道我们会做什么。
下一个问题。
So Krishna will what choice we'll make, right?
Huh? Krishna knows. Yeah, he knows what choice we're going to make.
那 Krishna 就是知道我们会做什么选择。下一个来自于 Taruni Lucy， 请问 Guru。Krishna 的安排超越物质自然定律，比如说有躯体的疾病的人一旦皈依 Krishna， 他病好与不好都是 Krishna 最好的安排，可以这样理解吗？ Taruni Tusi asked that the Krishna's arrangement transcend the material laws. For example, somebody, they are disease, they have disease, but as soon as they surrender to Krishna, and whether his disease will be recovered or not recovered, it's all due to Krishna. It's all the best arrangement of Krishna. Is this understanding right?
Yes, exactly right.
是的，这种理解是完全正确的。
下一个问题。
下一个，出题如何对大喜？明白过，昨晚梦中有一位讲课很好，非常资深奉献者，给我鸡肉，我还真吃了。实际上我已经开始祈祷咕噜忽悠我更好控制嘴巴心意，努力做合格学生。请问咕噜怎么看待昨晚吃肉的梦境呢？并且更好的规范修行。给我鸡肉哦，鸡肉。Shuti Rupa Devadasi said that yesterday she dreamed that there's a senior devotee gave her some chicken to eat, and she ate. And before that, she even prayed for Guru to control her tongue and mind, trying to be a qualified disciple. So how to see this dream and how to have a better sadhana about sadhana?
Well, you could see the dream that Krishna's warning you, be careful what you eat.
你应该这么看待，就 Krishna 在警告你对于你吃的东西要小心。
Be very careful. You're a devotee now. You've taken vows. You don't eat chicken.
你要非常小心，你现在已经是奉献者了，吃鸡肉了。
Before you used to eat everything, now you don't. Before becoming a devotee, you used to eat everything, but now you're a devotee, you cannot do that.
在成为奉献者之前呢，是什么都吃，那现在已经做了奉献者，就不能再这么做了。
下一个问题。
下一个问题，文言，顶拜咕噜，讲讲怎么具体控制心吗 ？So this devotee said, "Can you explain in details how to control the mind?"
Well, better you read the Bhagavad Gita.
你最好读一下佛家梵歌。
You read chapter 6, talks about controlling the mind.
国家梵歌第六章是控制心意的。
Actually, they're talking about Astanga Yoga, but they deal with the mind, about how the mind can be the friend, the mind can be the enemy, and you can conquer the mind, or you can be controlled by the mind, degraded by the mind. So you have to learn from the Bhagavad Gita.
第六章呢，讲的是八部瑜伽。但是呢，它就涉及到了怎样控制心意。心意既可以是成为敌人，也可以成为朋友，所以应该控制心，征服心意，而不要被心意所征服，不要被心意不要被心意，因为心意变得堕落。所以，请读一下《不叫梵歌》。
OK， 下一个问题。
下一个 ，Krishna Kumari。麦古鲁在《圣恩逍遥甘露》中有一段话 ：“Gaur Mohandey 试图相应的做出计划，但他根本无法猜测 Krishna 的计划，一切取决于 Krishna。而 Krishna， Krishna 高于民族主义，高于计划，高于星象法则，也高于一名谦逊的布商。希望将儿子变成，Srimati Radharani 的纯粹奉献者，并成为。”圣女国家兰的传教是这一愿望的，尤其是最后一句，请问教育方面对奉献者对下一代尽负定责任的正确心态还要不要做计划呢？奉献者在实际生活中过 So in the Srila Prabhupada Lilamrita, there is a paragraph that although Gaurav Mohan tried to make a plan, but he cannot gesture what will be Krishna's plan. Everything depends on Krishna, and Krishna is above nationalism, above all the plan, above astrology, and even above a humble merchant, close merchant, tried to make his son a pure devotee of Srimati Radharani and a preacher of Srimad Bhagavatam. So the especially the latter part, so the question is that as far as education is concerned, what's the proper mood for devotee to carry out his duty, her duty as to educate the next generation? And should this devotee make any plan?
Well, the proper duty to educate the future generations is to prepare them for liberation, that they will not take birth again. It said you should not become a mother or a father unless you can deliver your children from birth and death.
据说呢, 如果你不能把你的孩子从生死轮回当中拯救出来的话, 就不要为人父母。
That's the proper education.
这是正确的教育。
下一个问题。
第二, the next part of question is that 奉献者在实际生活中过于依附个人计划, 哪怕是服务为名, 是不是也是对 Krishna的不依附呢? In the practical life, devotee sometimes over-attached to personal plan, even in the name of service. So is this a kind of that devotee is not attached to Krishna?
Yes.
是的.
But your personal plan has to be in relation to Krishna consciousness.
但是您的个人计划也要和 Krishna知觉有关系。
If it's in relation to Krishna consciousness, then it's allowed. But if it's some independent program just for material desires, then it's not good.
If it's related to Krishna consciousness, it's good.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay. 如果你的计划是跟 Krishna知觉有关系的话，那个计划是好的。但如果是跟您个人的野心、个人的活动有关系，就不好。
Okay, 下一个问题.
下一个, Vivo 93. So her question is that sometimes the devotees are over attached to their personal plan. So is this okay, the next question. 顶拜孤入及奉献者, 赌优胆掉进天堂建筑师给五兄弟建造的宫殿的水池里, Krishna 鼓励大家嘲笑德的用意, 是想激恼德的吗? Best school devotees, Dudan has fallen into this pool of the Vishvakarma has constructed for Pandavas, but Krishna encouraged everybody to laugh at Dudan. Does that Krishna intend to incite or to anger Duryodhan?
Yes.
是的.
Because Duryodhan's not a devotee, because he's very proud.
Duryodhan 他不是奉献者, 他特别骄傲.
Duryodhan was opposed to the Pandavas. He wouldn't give the Pandavas any kingdom to rule.
他反对潘大 爸五兄弟，他甚至不给他们一块王国去统治。
Duryodhana was determined there must be a battle of Kurukshetra. There must be war.
Duryodhana 他一心就想发动这库尔之野战役。
So Krishna laughed. And he told other people to laugh.
所以 Krishna 就嘲笑了他，并且鼓励每个人嘲笑他。
So when you get laughed at, we should laugh too. We should think, funny, yeah? But very nice. We shouldn't feel difficulty. If we're humble, people are laughing at us, we should also laugh.
如果我们自己谦卑的话，就如果我们被嘲笑了，我们自己也会感到很好笑。
But Duryodhana didn't like, he saw people laughing at him, he felt very proud, he thought this is not good, they're laughing at me, they're supposed to worship me, they should respect me. He didn't like people laughing at him.
但是 Duryodhana 他特别骄傲，他觉得呢，他可被人嘲笑可不是件好事，是丢脸的，他应该是值得别人崇拜，值得受到尊重的。
好，下一个问题。
下一个 Panadeva Prabhu says thank you for your mercy, dear Maharaj Hare Krishna. And Shruti Rupa Dudasi, Hare Krishna.
Haribol?
Oh, okay. Shruti Rupa Dudasi can explain in details the dream that.Yes, she's in the dream, she ate the chicken, and also this is given by a very excellent devotee who can lecture very well in China. And in fact, she had been a vegetarian for 4 years, and during this time, she only ate sweet potato.And to have more time, and also to have less expense, so that to focus the mind in the study and the service. So she asked that the guru please bless me.
Bless you what? Bless you to keep eating sweet potatoes.
祝福你什么呢？祝福你，你吃红薯吗？
I don't know. We bless you always to remember Krishna.
Guru 祝福你永远记住 Krishna.
Be Vanti Krishna. Yong Yun, Be Vanti Krishna. Right? You should never forget Krishna.
永远记住 Krishna, 永远不忘 Krishna.
下一个问题。
下一个。So this devotee said that just now you mentioned he paid obeisance that you mentioned that the non-devotee if they suffer they will be more far away than, from Krishna. So how to understand this sentence?
Well, when the non-devotees suffer, they become more absorbed in their material situation.
当非奉献者受苦的时候，他们更加专注于他们的处境了。
And they lament more for their material body and their material condition.
他们就为他们的物质境况为他们的躯体而伤感。
They don't think that this is the mercy of Krishna. They're thinking, I'm so unfortunate. They're thinking, oh, I'm so unlucky. Oh, why this happened to me? They cannot understand.
他们不想这个是Krishna的仁慈，他们就是一味的在那里伤感，哦，我太不幸了，为什么这事发生在我身上啊，他们就不明白。
So in this way they become further and further away from Krishna.
就这样他们离Krishna就越来越远了。
Okay, so we will stop here today.
好，那今天。 今天就讲到这里。
Vama Ganshya Guru Mani Ki Vama Jantai Dufani Ganshya Sati Chujur Ganshya Soiru Fung Shensa Lingting Ganshya Nidawenti Jufuni Changsong Kwaila Hare Krishna
好，那我们感谢圣 Bhakti Vignanashna Singha Swamara 给我们带来的精彩的大布加瓦堂甘露早课，感谢所有奉献者的耐心聆听和提出的好问题，也感谢主持，希望大家有一个 Krishna 知觉的一天 ，Hare Krishna。
Srila Prabhupada ki，
在。
Gaur Bhakti Vrinda ki，
在。
Haribol。